So my cattle trailer's homemade, it's plywood. I was up there on that mountain there on a lookout, and it was awfully bumpy coming out. So anyway, I heard something move in this front panel. We'd originally intended this one as a door, and I guess the screws popped out. So I look in my rear view mirror, and there's a goat's head sticking out the hole there. Oh, pull over. So anyway, we're gonna go find some screws and put her back together. Apologize for the wind. Hopefully you can hear me. I thought I'd give you a good view. There's a nice little lookout here, turn off. Give you that view there. Sorry about the graffiti here. Isn't that just stunning? Absolutely marvelous. You just imagine living up here on the hill, other than the fact it is very, very windy here. That is beautiful. Going down a steep hill here again. It took us a while to crawl up the other side. Looks like beautiful scenery down the bottom again. Sorry for the dirty windshield. You can see the water whipping up some waves down in there. And now we're getting back into some mountainous terrain and closer to the water again. We were inland for a while, and now the road takes us back, as we get closer to Sault Ste. Marie, the road takes us back closer to the water. Something about water has such a calming effect. Oh, look, there's even a beach. Don't recommend laying on that beach right now. Looks cold. Stunning. You don't have to travel very far for a holiday when you live around here. Good morning, everyone. It is a little bit chilly, frosty out this morning here in Sudbury. We took the liberty of staying at this church parking lot last night. It's a Pentecostal church, I think. Right across from the Timmies. Although we didn't need the Timmies, just needed a place to crash and make my own coffee this morning. I did have a bit of an issue. I don't know what, but I ran out of heat last night. And under the van there, got antifreeze dropping down, so I don't know. If the overflow just, I don't know, if my van's not overheating, everything seems to be fine, but I have no heat in the van right now, so I'm going to take it for a cruise down the road and see if that helps. But yeah, it's 6 o'clock in the morning, the moon's up, the sun's on his way up, and we are going to hit the road again. We were hoping to make it all the way last night, but it was just, we would have got there at like 12 or 1 o'clock in the morning, so we thought we might as well go get some sleep first, and now we will head off down the road. Alright, so I'm not exactly sure. I might have to crawl underneath there later. I don't want to do it under my good coat, but I have heat now that I drove down the road. We went down, I don't know, maybe like 4 or 5 city blocks to the gas station here to fill up this morning. And yeah, as soon as I started driving, I had heat. So, I don't know. One thing Corey suggested is maybe the relief cap from the overflow. What do you want to call it? The overflow jug. The antifreeze, he said those things were problematic, so that maybe the air could get up. It could be that it just got warm and dumped a bunch of fluid down the hose. I don't know, not sure. Oh, the sun is fully up now. It is a beautiful day again. We are now getting close to Verner area. Verner was a contender for sure. It's a really nice area. I don't know if you can see some of the farmland out here. Looks like this one was just freshly tiled. If you're not familiar with that, it takes big drainage tiles and we put them in the ground every so many feet to help dry the ground up so you can get out there earlier for both seeding and harvesting. Very popular up here in the north especially, but most of Ontario is tiled. Not something we see in Saskatchewan. They don't do that there very often. Yeah, anyway, beautiful area here. We definitely considered this area as well. And if we can't find anything where we're going, I guess, like I said before, we're going to branch out from there into different ever-increasing circle to try to find a new home. So we have some friends living around this area as well. Don't know them super well, but we've been there a few times. Yeah, there's not as much rock here immediately, but not too far away. Very, very beautiful area though. Good farming community. Just coming into North Bay. It's very sunny. Sun's in my eyes. I'm not totally complaining. That's nice. But North Bay will be our major shopping center if this ends up becoming our home, which is the plan. We'll plan on buying around here. So this would be our major shopping center. It's got the big hospital right here. It's a massive hospital. It's got your Home Depots and your Walmarts and your all your big box stores are all here. Grocery shopping, everything you could probably want is in this town. I think, don't quote me, I can't remember, I think there's like 60,000 people living here or something like that. It's a decent sized city. So anyway, just rolling in through there now. I'm gonna pull over here someplace and wait for Corey. I don't see him behind me, he doesn't know where to turn. And I wouldn't mind a cup of coffee. I ran out of hot water here to make my own. So I've been making my own coffee basically the whole trip. But I will see if I can find something. Wouldn't mind another one. Everybody fared well. I gotta get the ducks out of there yet, but I let the geese go. They're happy to stretch their legs. Well, they could do that in there too, but have a bit more space. And the chickens, everybody did good. We even got an egg. We had two of them, but one was broke. So they still have water and food. I just gotta get the ducks out of there and a couple of bunnies and give them something to eat.
whole bunch of
Hey.
Just getting ready to unload the wrapper.
What a nice sunny day. I've been out stretching my legs now for quite a while and just had some coffee here. It's very nice to get out of the vehicle. We are busy putting, I feel kind of bad. I'm filling up his whole yard with stuff everywhere. I got the wrapper unloaded here. I'm going to put these totes of feed that I took along in the back of his barn, and then the implements will all get parked in the yard here with tractors and stuff. And then I still got the ducks in there. And the chickens, gonna take them back to his house. They actually don't live on this yard. Their house is just down the road a little bit. So we'll bring them there, and the chickens can stay in the cages, but the ducks and the geese will get to roam around. Hey, that's it for today, folks. We're gonna get this stuff put away, and we will catch you again on the next one. Thanks for joining us.